two New South Wales fathers will meet the state attorney general today to try and have manslaughter charges reinstated against the Hunter bus crash driver Brett Button. Joining us live now is Adam Bray, father of Hunter bus crash victim Zach Bray. Adam, it's good to see you. Thank you so much for your time this morning. I still cannot imagine how difficult things are for you and other family members at the moment. So what do you hope comes out of today's meeting?
Yeah, it is difficult, obviously. It remained difficult. So we just draw on resilience and focus for justice for our children, for our brothers, you know, brothers, sisters, wives, husbands, etc. The magnitude of this is enormous.
Yeah.
So what we're hoping for today is pretty simple. Sally Downing, the DPP, and her team have done a backflip on manslaughter charges, which they had agreed and informed all victims, families, and survivors that they were rolling forward with like 5 weeks ago. 24 hours before the proceedings, the plea to proceedings for Button, guilty or not guilty, we were informed that they were doing a backflip and going with lesser serious charges, which don't match the crime. You know, this is manslaughter 101.
Yeah, so that's what I wanted to ask you. Why was the guilty plea, which, as you mentioned there, in exchange for a lesser penalty, not enough?
Well, it's not enough because if you look at the signed statement of facts which flow off the back of a guilty plea and signed by Mr. Button, it's very clear. You know, this is a opium addict. This is a driver who has not disclosed to his employer of his drug abuse and overdosage. The readings, you know, in his body, the police took, you know, after he stood there and looked at mutilated bodies in a bus that he'd capsized, and didn't assist in the emergency efforts at all. Now that's just a doped up, you know, individual who actually knew what he was doing. He knew he was doped up. He knows he's committed crime. So once again, very poor character to try to plead to lesser charges.
Do you think he's remorseful?
To be honest, I don't care who's remorseful. There's no sorry that fits, you know, that is fitting in this situation. The reality is, you know, you've killed 10 people, you've maimed 25 with some very serious injuries that do get forgotten, unfortunately. But and the extent on the wider community, on the families, the mental health issues, the challenges rolling forward, this is a massacre with catastrophic, you know, coverage. And it's and obviously that's the Attorney General's job, and the Sally Dowling, the Director of Public Prosecutors, their job, the reason they're in those honourable positions is to do the right thing by the public.
And are you hopeful? How confident are you ahead of this meeting today? And what sort of a meeting do you think it'll be with the Attorney General? Will it be anger, or will it be something else?
It won't be anger. It'll be objective. I've spent a lot of time, over weeks actually with criminal lawyers who defend, some pretty bad characters and understand criminal law exceptionally well. So. It'll be a meeting with data, facts, with case history on the Buxton, driver, most recently, and another two which are very relevant. Out of those three, one carried manslaughter, the other two have aggravated driving, causing death. We don't even have that. So these charges, these secondary, which were backup charges to manslaughter, they're not the primary charges. But the primary charges are manslaughter. The DPP, to try to have a win, get another one cleared off the table, save the public coffers, whatever is their motivation, we do not know.
Okay.
So we'll find out today.
Adam Bray, again, thank you so much for your time this morning. We'll check up on you again, see how that progresses.